everyone really enjoy this day, especially two practices from Professor Asinta and Carlos Sanchavi. And I remember that a few minutes ago, I have a lot of questions. I'm sure that you will have a lot of questions about something what we passed already yesterday. But I will use this short speech to present the people who stay or sit in front of you. Staff of Westprem, who just finished Final Four in Cologne in this great final with Barcelona. Xavi and Carlos arrived in Westprem 3 years ago. Right. They are connected already 12 years, first in Antequera, 7 years,
six years,
and now in Westprem. And as I told you yesterday, Carlos is not just a coach what you know today. Carlos was one of the greatest Spanish players all the time. Played about 150 times for Spanish national team, took a bronze medal in Sydney against Yugoslavia in that match. And silver and bronze medal in European Championship. He was a six-time European champion with his club, Barcelona. Actually, he's stayed 11 years in Barcelona almost all his career from Malaga. They call him silent or quiet man from Malaga, usually. He's not so quiet on the court, as you recognize. And all his career is connected with Malaga, from where he came, and Barcelona. He was one of the famous players of Barcelona, one of the best scorers ever in Spanish league. Six-time Champions League, six-time Spanish League, many times Supercopa, Asobal League, Pyrenees League, whatever competition, I don't know how many cups there. And it's really great pleasure to have Carlos and Xavi, staff who just finished really long year in Second Liga. They won the title. They won almost 97-98% of the matches in this season, and it's a great pleasure to have them here and to listen to their presentation. Enjoy the evening, actually. I see you.
Good evening, one more time. I'm going to introduce ourselves a little bit more. No? I'm not a light player. Player is the class. I just finished 3 years ago. Now I'm coach, and yesterday we were speaking about we thinking as a coach. This is true, from the beginning this is true. In my first year, I was thinking like a player yet, no? This is history, no? Now I feel like a coach. My age, like players were amazing. I never in my life forget it. I have on my soul, I have on my heart. Would be good, but never is it going to come back. So now, as a coach, we start together 12 years ago exactly. When I was player yet in Barcelona, I start as a second coach of Xavi. Xavi was a player too, goalkeeper, and he was training the sub
13 years old
Barcelona team. I finished my career like coach for the university way, not for the Spanish Federation way, and I had to finish. I had to do a memory one year like second coach and a memory to send and everything. No? I mean with Xavi. We were studying in the university. I did it with Xavi this year. No? And the year after, Xavi went to play to Malaga in the. The second league, Spanish league, and I take directly the first the as a coach this team, no, the sub 13 years. Okay, it was my last season as a player in Barcelona. I had a big problem on my knee after 3-4 operation. I decided I couldn't play my level, and I decided to finish. So, I back. To my hometown, to Malaga, to take a team in second league in a little town of Malaga, Antequera. Of course, I asked Xavi to come with me because we We had a lot of confidence. I think we made a great team. And the asset, the offer, and we took Antequera in second league, in the Spanish league. The Spanish league was really, really, really amazing. The second league was really, really amazing. It was a great players. We were new. But I had an advantage, this is clear, I had an advantage that I was player, I was important player, and because of this, basically, the player respect me a lot. This was clear. And part of this, I think, like we spoke yesterday, if we feel confident with our work, the players feel that you are working good and believe truth in you more and more. So this year we finished first in the second league. We were to Liga Sobal, and after this we were playing 5 years in Liga Sobal, doing, in my opinion, good job. We were not a big team with a big budget, and we made really good season, always between 8th and 11th position. And this year, one more time, this year were amazing. The Liga Sobal was good. There were three teams always fighting for the league, for the title. And after this, there were three or four teams fighting for the European competition. And after the rest, no? And we were always the first of this group, no? Okay, we had to, because of economical reason, we had to leave Antequera. But you know, we were working in absolute confidence with the player. We were thinking only about finish the season the best as possible, and we were not thinking about our future. When we decided to leave the club, it was Maine, and we couldn't find another place. The places were closed, no? So, and Liga Sobal started to go down. The last year, and especially after this, the last year. So, we finished, and suddenly, I like this, I want to continue Sobal with this. No? We had some offer, some option in the Spanish league, but we feel that the Spanish league were down and down and down. We didn't find any place the first year, and at the end we realized that if we want to continue with this, we have to find place outside, because Spanish league is almost over. Only Barcelona in this moment, and maybe Logroño are probably the others are amateur, no? Suddenly we had amazing luck, and we find maybe the best option ever we can find, no? In Cabe Vespe. And this was a big chance for us, no? Because big chance and a big challenge, because we have to work with amazing player, with big pressure. In the club, they always want to win and to win and try to arrive as far as possible. Until now, I think we are doing a good job. We are extremely, extremely fortunately guys. We are working there 3 seasons ago. We have 2 more years contract. We hope to finish this contract. And this is our history, no? I'm telling this about, especially for the coaches, because you never know when the luck is in your side, no? I feel that you especially are so to motivate coach. This is good. And you never know when the luck is knocking to your door. You have to be ready, you have to be working. Now you are in Greece. 5 years ago, or 4 years ago, we were unemployed. No? Okay, this is like introduced, no? Now we are going to speak one more time. Basically, it's the same that we were the other day, no? But with picture, you can see more clear
the work that we did, what we did yesterday, and how we understand how we have to attack the 5-1 or open defense in this case. Okay, to attack on the open defense, there are a lot of theory.
There are a lot of theory. Every people have his opinion, every people sometimes too much complicate. And that's okay. And the coaches, we sometimes make brainstorm about how or what we have to do, how we have to do circulation, transformation, move, stay in one side, don't move, play without ball, play, move, change the position. We have a lot of theory. Everybody has a coach inside, no? And in my opinion, the most important in handball, the most important is to do good or to do very good the easy things. This is the most important. So if you have very good one against one, very good one against one, the team has to look for some ways to open the defense to you looking for this one against one. And after this, take the good decision. Shoot, pass, whatever. This is the most important. Sometimes to make complicated things, circulation after you come be here, back, before nothing. Sometimes with a small situation or easier situation, but if you dominate this situation, it's more than enough. For example, we are going to put here some picture that I think these two pictures we tried to work yesterday, no? Sometimes to do easy, good thing, to do good, the easy things is the best way to attack every kind of defense. Oh, for example, in this case we have, this was the third and fourth, stop, sorry. This was the third and fourth, position against Barcelona last season in third and fourth. Okay, and they were in 5-1. In this situation, what do we play? Stop. Chema play without ball, open the top player and stop. And we create, or he, in this case, create a big space to Laszlo, play this 2-against-2, big space. And after he play without ball, and stop. What option we have? Laszlo shoot. Second, 2-against-2, pass, third, cross, defend, or pass here or there. And it's an easy situation. Only we separate the top player. And remember that yesterday we spoke about, depend with what kind of player you have to play. Oh, this morning you are, and now you, so, in this case, it's Laszlo. In this case, it's Laszlo who played this 2-against-2, because Laszlo is better player playing 2-against-2 than 1-against-1. But if, for example, in this position is playing this season Christian Sainz, maybe we can work with the pivot, or we can put with the pivot between first and second to looking for 1-against-1, because Sainz is better looking for 1-against-1 or this quick shoot that he has. Okay, and this is for example one. And another situation is, here is top. Vista against Barca, the only match that played lose Barca this season, that they played, yesterday we were working. Stop, this guy between first and second, this guy doesn't play too very, very good this situation, because he has to fix a little bit more Victor Tomás, and he open more, so he can open more. But what they are going to looking for? Serenovic, 1-against-1 to Sorraindo. Okay? They find the shoot and goal. one more example, one more time. Okay, stop. It's good. But if this player open a little bit more space for the other. It's not only the attack is not only the thing that has to do the player who is going to start the attack. The other has to do as best as possible to try that the player who is going to attack find the best comfort, the best thing to do his attack, no? Okay. In attack, you know, you have to have intention, no? And we are going to separate the kind of the intention in two ways. We make a small presentation about this: individual tactic intention and collective tactical intention. We are going to speak about both. About individual tactical intention, okay? We separate with ball and without ball. We are going to start to speak with ball. First of all, fix your opponent. How you can fix your opponent? You can fix your opponent direct, not to fix, stop with them. Or your opponent and one more. This is to fix. Okay, here one example, in the same match, Barcelona best friend last season. Okay, Chema took the left back, stop, and he fixed his opponent and one more guy. And after, one more thing good. He took the right decision. Okay, you have to be dangerous. It's not enough, okay, we're going to play. He's going to start. No. You have to be dangerous. And this, I have to, if I am going to attack, feed my opponent and one more. Perfect. But if he's going to attack another guy, I have to fix a little bit. Man, because if I open a little bit more space for the other. This is a collective game. So, no, you're going to attack, okay. Hey, for you. No, we have to collaborate always. Pass. Okay, one more example. Okay, remember that yesterday we tried to play this 2-2 with top player, no? The same case, Chema 2-2 with the top player, with the pivot, and he decides where is the goal. Fantastic. Okay?
Weak sense pass.
Okay. Continue. If you want to comment something, we can speak, no problem. It's not only a monologue. Okay, finta. We classify finta, especially in its open defense, in three ways. Okay? First of all, normal finta. One against one. All the finta are one against one usually. But we classify in another way. Okay, for example, the same match. Our clear example today is Chema. One against one. Okay? We play with a shared position. And one against one. Second, play good. This is very important in open defense. And especially, like right here, against 3-1. Play good with the feet of our step and the pose or pose. Yesterday, I was coming to you sometime, right back. Hey, why you are spending the bone so early? No, you have 3 steps. This is gold. This is one of the rich things of our sport. So why I spend the bones without nothing? I have 3 steps before. I can play with the 3 steps. 1, 2, 3. And after I can, until the 4, I can play. I can do more things. So this is a thing that very important to work. Very important to be rich about this. Huh? Especially, one more time, against 3-1. Why? Because in 3-1, when you put 2 pivots, the top player is always in the middle. And the top player is disturbing the length of the pass and the center back is moving with the ball. So this player, if you make ducks, we can discount them. Okay, this in my team, the guy who made this better without ducks, one more time is Chema. Okay, for example, this is to play with the thick of the steps. You know, Chema receives the ball, 1, 2, 3, balls, and he decides one more time where is the goal. This was a big skill, the semifinal this season. It's super. Okay, and play with the finta pass and finta shoot. The same. It's similar, but not, it's not the same one I mean. And especially with 3-2-1. The same. 3-2-1. Two pivot, Jiha in the middle, for example. If you play too easy, if you jump, you spend the bones, and you jump, if you don't have this side, you are dead. So it's better. Play with the feet on the floor, finta shoot, finta pass, and everything. One more example about Chema. The same match. Okay, feint across, pass to the pivot. And this is to play. One, two, and feint a pass. This is complete. Okay, continue. First, shoot, of course. You have to dominate the shoot. One more example, block Barcelona. No, no, Zagreb, Barcelona, and this good example. The important thing are the details always. The details are very important. In this case, Sarmiento played this 2-2, no? With Sorraindo. He didn't find the solution, but he collaborated with his mate. He passed, made the cross, and pushed his other opponent, the opponent of Karabatic. And he opened the space to Karabatic to find the shoot. This is super. One more time. Okay? He played 2-2. Stop. The defense play good. They resolve this 2-2. Stop. They resolve the 2-2. He didn't find the solution with the pivot and with the shoot. He continues, he gives the cross and push his indirect opponent. And after this, Karabatic went to this space credit for Sarmiento. What can happen? First, shoot. Second, he goes, pass to the pivot. These little details are very important in handball. The difference between the good player and the great player are the details. And combination of all of some of them. All of them. Okay, this one is example after goal. Against Kiel the other day. Quickly after goal, this is top. We're speaking. Handball is complete. It's not only defense. And now, every day, you know, every people is playing more, faster and faster. If you see some match 20 years ago, when I was player in Barcelona, you had, or 30 years ago, more, you had time to change two, three, you had time to change the six players, if you wanted. But now, if you change two, you start to have a lot of problems. You have to be good organized. And we play quickly. After this, Chema went 1-1 directly to Jiha. Momo continued with the cross. Continue. Stop. He played without ball and he find the solution, running, receiving, running. One more time. Okay, continue with this and the tactical individual intention without ball, we divide it in two, okay? Support the player with the ball, basically. It's basic, this is basic. In this situation, last season, one more, well, then. Stop, okay? This guy made pressure over Christian Ugalde, and Christian Ugalde went out to support, and it's easier to play this situation because Christian Ugalde is helping. And the next one, receive running. This is clear. Receive running in a sport, in open defense, in 6-0, whatever, is very important. If you play stop it, you have nothing. You are going to need always the ball. And the balls it's important to use always after something. Without running, you have less power to play one against one, to play something. Okay? This is an example before. Chema play one more time, one against one. And Laszlo, continue. Receive running. Do you remember yesterday? Where is you? Do you remember yesterday that he told, hey, he played these two against two, and you are over there? Receive running. Me and running. Okay, this is about individual. About collective tactical intention, we can play. What we can play? First, pass and go, everybody knows. Okay, pass and go. Penetrations. Cross or crosses. Cross with a ball. With a ball. Block. Screen. Go to second pivot. Against open defense. From the first line or from the second line, with ball, without ball, up to you. Okay. How you can do it? How you can do it? We make here. Okay, make bigger the defense. Yeah? The rule of the width against open defense. Attack outside areas, very important. One example. In open defense, you make bigger always the defense if you attack open defense. In this case, we not only against Key one more time, we not only attack to outside, we find the solution, so much better. One more repetition. Okay. Balls fast parallel to the wing. And you have to have good wings to finish, because usually this kind of defensive are going to have to shoot for the wing more than others. And you have to prepare, you have to be ready for this. Okay? Ball arrives to the wing. Super. How? Play. Yesterday we were working this, if you remember. Play against the top player. How? One against one, or yesterday, like yesterday, we were playing two against two with the people. Okay? Then we saw this example. Yeah? This is a complex example. Because Shema went one against one against Jiha, and Momo continues attack. This is a sample of continuity. Or two against two against the player. We saw this. Two against two. The difficult of this is not to play this two against two. Stop. Maybe everybody is ready to play two against two. But at good teams, usually resolve good this situation. The difficulty is to this guy to take the decision. See and find what is the goal. And he passed. Bad side, absolutely perfect. Very important against open defense, very important. Attack, a play in the back of the player. Play in the back of the player. How? The ball or the player? You have to pass the ball on the back or with the player playing the back. Why? Because if we make this, the other five who are down has more space to defend, big space. So more easy to attack if you can find this solution. We put a couple of, maybe we watch this, but important. Here, Chema pass the ball on the back of the top player. And in that case, this pawn, I don't remember his name, he play on the back of the top player and find the goal. Okay, it's a clear example. One more time. They play with two pivots. Stop. OK? Okay, what happened here? These five guys has a big space because he didn't disturb. One rule of the open defense is the top player never can allow to play in our back. If not, problems. But they find the solution and big space and they found a great goal. And attack to the space between second and top player. It's similar as the first, but it's not the same. Always between stop. In this interval, there are big space. So we have to find solution to try to attack. Here with a chain of position. Semaphore one against one. I think I remember it was all. Okay, attack. We continue with this, with the collective tactical. Play, we change the position. If you change the position, the defense has to move too. You are doing dabs, great dabs for the defense. Here is an important. Wait. Close. Read, you have to read what is going to do the top player. Because you can move the position and the top player can keep the position or can move other side. So the attack could be different depending on who is doing the top player. Okay, this was this season. Kill 6 seconds. Okay, stop. You know, he opened. They play without ball. And one more thing, Gia tried to help Gia without ball. So they're going to look for this. So this two is two. If they are not ready, he has this pass, shoot, pass, or cross. After cross, they fall the pivot. Okay? And everything continues. Everything depends what this guy is going to do. Stop. Stop. Okay. In this case, Jonas Kalman keeps the center. So this guy has to attack to this interval to find, to create attacks and to find the solution. If Jonas Kalman go to this side with Tiha, he has big space to play these two against two and finish the attack with the shoot. Tiha is a big shooter, as you know. Play with double pivot from the first or the second line. And one more time, always read. What is doing the top player? As I told you yesterday, in my case, but there are a lot of theories. I prefer against open defense play with second pivot with the first line, because as I told you yesterday, if you go with the wing, there are some teams that can be dangerous with the top player, the war of the top player. So in this case, we work without ball, to second pivot. Okay, remember that we were working this yesterday. Back without ball, he tried to get the position, and he is holding. One more example, stop. As you remember, yesterday, then we were working similar this. Open, Chema open, fantastic, to him. And now we put the people outside to look for one against one. And Lasso went to the shoot. Okay, in this case, Chema can help a little bit more. Play without ball. Important. Important. It's not only to play without ball to go to second pivot. It's playing without ball when your opening is here, try to do dissuasion, and you go without ball and receive here, you are more dangerous. And especially with open defense, because there are more spaces. We put this example one more time. Okay? Here, Christian's side went without ball. So he followed and Laszlo found the solution.
Another play, another way to attack. Play with two pivots. We didn't find 5-1. But with this, what you want? If you play with two pivots, especially against 3-1, it's good. But against 5-1, what can happen? They keep 5-1. It's better for us to play 5-1 against two players. They can go down. It's another way to attack directly with two pivots all the time. I suppose a coach will change. If they have problem, will change the defense. But you win. You start winning. If they change the defense, okay, you can start after to change two. And one, as I told you yesterday too, 7-6. Is now, I think more people are thinking about this. It's a risk. It's a risk, but I think that could be the future. Could be the future. If you play good, everybody has clear what they have to do. In fact, we found last European Championship in Hungary. The girls are starting to do it that. Denmark,
Hungary. We saw some pictures, some images. Okay, you see, they put the beep. The playmaker, two pivots. And it's clear another way, total, open defense, or close defense, you have one more. In this case, we are speaking about open defense. This is one, and this is another way. Okay? There are a lot of, you can put the beep here, near on the bench. Every coach has his theory. And you can put the pivot open, the pivot closed, every coach has his theory. Okay? This is basically it. About 5-1. If you have some question about this, will be a pleasure to try to answer you. And we leave the next one, our mails and our contact. If you want to take some contact with us, for us it's a pleasure. Somebody have some question? Sabitri. No question. Okay, this is our mail. This is our mail, and thank you so much for your attention.
Okay, before I inform you about tomorrow's program, I have to say once again thanks for three persons who spent these 2 days with us and who will leave us tomorrow morning, some of them very early, some of them after breakfast, and say big thanks. It was a pleasure to enjoy your company, Alessandro, Charlie and Carlos, and wish you very good luck to take good rest after the long season, to continue with the Master Coach Seminar.